I'm Elie Setback, reporting.
Yo.
What up, Mr. Lion?
Where you at?
I'm right here. I was training my dog right now. We're doing some dog training sessions right now.
What's up with it?
Chilling. You back in town?
Yeah, I'm back in town. I'm gonna get people in my family right now.
Nice. I got Elie Setback in the car with me. We wanted to congratulate you on the big knockout on this past Saturday, man.
Yeah, appreciate it. You know, y'all my boy.
Man, you look great, man. I wish you would fight Cotto next.
They don't want it.
Yeah, but can you imagine if you put him to sleep like that?
I'll try to throw out a bullet on it. They don't bite.
Yeah, I know.
Everything good with you, Charlo?
I'm a cool black over there.
Swing by the gym, man.
Yeah, I already know I will.
All right, brother. Take care, man. Nice seeing you. Say what's up to everybody.
I appreciate
you. All right, later.
I'll tell my uncle and everybody.
Bye.
Okay. He said he tried to make the Cotto fight, and they wanted nothing to do with it.
Yeah, I don't think so. I heard Freddie told me that was going to be, what's his name's last fight against Ali.
Yeah.
So.
Well, that's what they say. I've never seen a fighter really retire. Am I wrong?
I was like Pacquiao, I mean.
He retired after Mayweather, right?
Yeah.
Then he came back.
Came back, fought again. We'll see what happens.
A lot of people retired and came back, so yeah. We'll see.
Carras is fighting also.
Yeah, he retired too a few times.
A few times. He's coming back.
He's an exciting fighter. I hope he wins his next fight.
Well, Brandon retired. He came back.
Yeah.
And he looked good.
Yeah.
Mm. But don't get me wrong. He fought the right opponent. And that's the way it's supposed to be. A lot of people don't understand boxing. You know, when you come back from a retirement, you don't want to go in there with a hard fight.
You want to end your career.
Yeah, you want to make a nice comeback and make a tune-up fight.
And
that's the way it's supposed to be.
Yeah.
A few tune-up fights. But when you're a veteran like Brandon, you know, you got to be up to the plate, you know, because your career is almost towards the end. You retire already for a reason. You want to come back and you look good. And then you get another big fight and hope to look impressive and win. So that's what's going on right now. You know, Charlo look tremendously.
Charlo said you're his boy. He comes to visit you in the gym.
That's my boy.
He has a lot of power, a lot of skill, a lot of talent. Maybe underrated fighter, one of the best fighters underrated. They don't give enough credit for how good he is. But he's the 154 champion.
There you go. His brother went up to 160.
He's a champion.
So there you go. There you go, Elie. Of boxing, it ain't an easy sport. Now, a lot of fighters out there want to make their comments about, he's a bum.
There are no bums in boxing.
There's none at all. Not even the taxi drivers. It just takes a lot of heart and balls to get in that ring.
Yeah. No, you're right. It's a lot of dedication, making weight, working out every day, having a dream, having. People could talk, but then they step in the ring to spar and they bitch out.
Oh,
bitch. It's like now. You know how many people would never let a dog to bite him like that, Ricky? Shows balls.
Man, that hurts me right now. Does it hurt you?
No, I can feel it, but it doesn't hurt. Fuck it.
You.
Hey, tacos, man.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Setback, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Setback. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Setback.